Amerikanen die nieuws over de Europese politiek sexy maken. Met die brandende ambitie gaat de nieuwssite Politico volgende week van start in Brussel. In de VS zelf is Politico al langer een begrip met een website, krant en magazine. En onder meer Obama himself is daar een fervent lezer van. Na Washington wil Politico nu dus ook Brussel veroveren. Bart Aerts.
It's a magazine, right?
Information of EU affairs. Are you from Politico?
They're coming here. Starting next week.
Politico neemt zijn intrek op de zesde verdieping van de Residence Palace in het hart van de Europese wijk in Brussel. Op 21 april lanceert Politico een website, een reeks betalende nieuwsbrieven, een krant en een magazine.
It's like, you know, when your wife is 8 months pregnant and is due next week and there's a lot of anxiety. You know, you sort of done the scan, you see the baby is healthy and you know, it's got 2 arms, 2 legs, but you're not quite sure how the birth will go and what the, you know, the baby will be exactly like. I think that's where we are.
In de States is Politico sinds 2006 een begrip en bereiken ze iedere maand 7 miljoen lezers. Goed voor een jaaromzet van 15 miljoen euro.
Now people are oversaturated with information. So it's harder to earn the eyeball of a reader. And what differentiates us is because our journalism echoes, because people have to reckon with it, because policymakers have to read it, because the president has to read it, it puts us at the very top of the stack.
Obama is een fervent lezer. In Europa nam Politico het weekblad European Voice over, met steun van de uitgever van Bild en Die Welt.
Yeah.
40 topjournalisten heeft hij in Brussel. Met dat team wil hoofdredacteur Kaminski ook de Europese leiders abonnee maken.
Merkel, Hollande, Cameron will read Politico?
I very much expect them to. Them and their, you know, European aides, chief European aide. I think Mario Draghi should be added to your list. You know, back in the US, we think you know, a lot of people who will have a very big interest in what's happening in Europe. You know, Donald Tusk, I very much expect to be a reader. But you hit at a very fundamental point for us, that we are a publication for primarily for decision makers, primarily people who really have who are part of that community of people who runs the show. It's not that we're elitist, it's just that's who we are writing for. We have to be indispensable for those people. Otherwise, we don't really have a great publication, and then we don't have a great business.
Their ambition is to make European politics sexy. Is that even possible?
Sexy? It's possible, I think. Look around.
I think like making real information about what is happening inside, because there are a lot of things happening. And good things, not only bad things. So it can be sexy.
So how you can make it sexy? I think you promote it to more people, you bring it closer to the people, so they really understand what's going on.
Well, I don't see how anyone thinks that European politics are boring. Ask a Spaniard or a Greek whether, you know, what happens in Brussels is relevant to their day-to-day lives. And it's also relevant to everyone's life here. Just on the sexiness point, it is impossible for me to understand why, when you have so much money at stake and you have such big political interests colliding, how that's not fundamentally interesting to a political junkie, a policymaker, and often a general reader. You know, the story about Google versus the European Commission, you know, this is a, for the company, but for the way we use our computer, that's a huge story.
They interviewed people on the street and asked them, taxi drivers, and said, and if you saw Mrs. Cruz right now, what's the one thing you would say to her? And the guy was like, I wouldn't talk to her, I'd just run her over. But maybe what would you do next? I'd run over her again.
Politico wil een mix brengen van politiek nieuws, analyses in de diepte en ook roddels.
You call it gossip, I may call it kind of inside dirt. But people really want to know what's happening behind the scenes. People want to know what those people are like, are really like? You know, what's that prime minister really like? You know, why is he doing what he's doing, or she's doing what she's doing? How do they relate to each other, these leaders? People like the human drama, which is the heart of politics, going back to Julius Caesar and Pericles in Athens.
Van het oude Athene terug naar Brussel, maar daar houdt het niet op. De komende maanden posteert Politico ook journalisten in Berlijn, Parijs, Londen, Moskou en Warschau. Meteen het meest grensoverschrijdende netwerk gericht op Europese verslaggeving.
En vanaf volgende week dus te raadplegen.